Hello, and this presentation will cover creation history and implementation details of simple extension built on top of official MongoDB Scala driver. I would say that spray.json is lightweight Scala library for JSON serialization, and currently it's maintained by Akka team at Lightband. MongoDB is NoSQL database that stores records as JSON documents. Official MongoDB Scala driver was introduced in September 2015. By default, the driver provides support only for JSON documents. And it may be necessary to implement additional JSON codecs to successfully work with custom user data types. Current slide shows main components of application that works with various internal and external user web services and uses MongoDB to store the data. Usually, JSON formats should be implemented to serialize these models to REST API requests and responses. And in addition, JSON codecs should be implemented to save these models to MongoDB. Code on this slide defines test model details as well as related JSON protocol and JSON codec for this model. Current slide shows implementation details of a simple test JSON codec encode method that uses simple writer to write these model details. And this slide shows implementation details of JSON codec decode method. Pretty similar. And this test codec can be used to insert the data. However, in this case, driver will throw error during attempt to read this data back. Code on this slide presents additional changes in the JSON codec to read test model fields by name. We added number, ID, and command fields names. But in this case, another error will be thrown when reading data with incorrect order. This is the previous errors were expected because JSON contains ordered k-value pairs. Main idea is pretty straightforward. MongoDB stores records as JSON documents, and JSON is binary JSON, and typical application already has JSON formats for the models, and it should be possible to reuse existing JSON formats to read and write these models from and to MongoDB, and skip implementation of JSON codec. The Scala driver supports reading and writing JSON documents represented as MongoDB extended JSON. Let's walk through the main idea one more time. If application works with many API services, then JSON formats already defined for all these models. And because MongoScala driver allows to create JSON documents from JSON, it should be possible to reuse our existing JSON formats and skip implementation of JSON codecs. Current slide explains transformation pipeline. Custom data type is defined in the application. Spray.json represents this type as JSON. MongoDB Scala driver creates JSON document from this JSON. And MongoDB finally stores the data document in binary format. Current slide explains how to build JSON document from test entity JSON using existing test JSON protocol. Note that second find query selects the document from MongoDB and prints JSON. And this find query uses existing test JSON protocol to transform JSON to test case class instance. It works well. This slide shows example of inserting document with large long number. And this find query will throw exception because existing JSON protocol uses long JSON format defined in spray.json library. This would be different for MongoDB extended JSON as it presented long numbers as objects with number long key. Long JSON format is defined as an object in default JSON protocol, which makes it impossible to override serialization logic for this data type. And at the same time, Scala compiler follows Liskov substitution principle and doesn't allow to hide this format in subclasses. Note that Scala allows to hide imports. The current slide demonstrates how to hide long JSON format from import and define new one. On the current slide, find query uses updated test JSON protocol to deserialize JSON that contains large long field to test case class instance. No errors thrown, works as expected. However, this trick made it impossible to use JSON protocol for rest of the types, our test JSON protocol. As such, provided find query will not compile because test JSON protocol doesn't have JSON format for int type now. To run find query by int number, JSON formats from default JSON protocol should be imported as presented on this slide. Unfortunately, in this case, first query by long ID will not compile because long JSON format is available in both JSON protocols now, in default JSON protocol and in test JSON protocol. To solve this issue, long JSON format should be hidden from the import again. After that, all queries will work as expected. First query by long ID number and second by int number. To prevent various issues related to incorrect or multiple imports of JSON formats, it's better to define new JSON protocol. Code on current slide emphasizes the main idea of Greenleaf JSON protocol trait. The new trait provides all JSON formats from default JSON protocol, but defines them as non-final values to make possible override JSON-specific formats. Current slide contains code of JSON-specific long format implementation in additional Greenleaf JSON protocol, as required in MongoDB extended JSON to serialize this data to JSON. And this slide provides example of usage of Greenleaf JSON protocol and Greenleaf JSON protocol to define separate JSON and JSON protocols for our test entity. Current slide shows expected representation of the test entity in JSON format. And this slide shows expected MongoDB extended JSON representation for JSON format of test entity model. Current slide presents the code of deserialization of JSON to test case class instance along with two related find queries. Both queries work well with single import of test JSON protocol. So far, Greenleaf JSON and Bison protocols were used to serialize basic types, such as int and long. However, they also support various common types, such as enumeration and zone date time. Scala enumeration defines a set of specific values, and each enumeration value has two parameters, numeric ID field and string field name. Greenleaf JSON protocol provides two helper methods to easily create enumeration JSON format by either numeric ID or by string name. Code on current slide defines test code entity with enumeration stock symbol field and related JSON formats. In this case, both defined JSON and Bison protocols will transform entities to JSON with string value of stock symbol field. Next, about object ID type. By default, object ID data type is used for primary key in MongoDB. Greenleaf protocol serialize object ID to plain string for JSON by default. Greenleaf Bison protocol overrides object ID JSON format to serialize this type as required in MongoDB extended JSON for Bison documents. Sorting an object ID value is roughly will have roughly the same effect as sorting by creation time. Code on current slide defines test entity message with object ID field and related JSON and Bison protocols. Code on this slide creates instances of message case class with different text field values and insert all of them into MongoDB collection. Code on current slide demonstrates that sorting on object ID value will print messages ordered by creation time. Another important notice about sorting on object ID field. Object ID values created within the same second don't have guaranteed ordering. Next type is UUID, and Greenleaf JSON protocol serializes UUID data type to string by default. However, it's possible to override this JSON format in Bison protocol if needed. Zone date time is an immutable representation of date time with a time zone. Greenleaf JSON protocol implements zone date time JSON format as shown on this slide. Bison documents store date as an object that contains key field date and the value as the number of milliseconds since the Unix epoch. Related implementation of zone date time JSON format in Greenleaf Bison protocol presented on the current slide. This example defines log message entity with timestamp field and related JSON and Bison protocols. Current slide contains code that prints expected JSON representation of log messages. And expected Bison representation of log messages appeared on this slide. All timestamps presented as JSON objects with date key and numeric value. Date before Unix epoch represented as negative value, Unix epoch represented as zero, and other dates represented as positive numbers. As per official MongoDB documentation, MongoDB JSON parser currently doesn't support loading string representation dates pre-Unix epoch. Current slide contains example of code with dates prior the Unix epoch in numbers and string formats. Related Bison documents will contain negative values in all such cases without showing any errors. Bigdecimal is another common data type in Scala that represents decimal 128 floating point numbers. Bigdecimal JSON format already defined in Sprite.json. Current slide contains code that defines test model with bigdecimal field, related protocols, and insert test entities to MongoDB collection. Find query on the current slide will transform Bison documents to test mathematical constant instances without errors. However, bigdecimal fields in this case will lose precision. By default, MongoDB saves all numbers as 64-bit double values. Bigdecimal should be stored in special number decimal format. Code on current slide overrides bigdecimal JSON format to use MongoDB specific number decimal type. Test entities in this case will be deserialized without losing any precision in values, as bigdecimal represented as number decimal format now. JSON is an unordered k value pairs. Bison is ordered k value pairs. And important to remember that renaming of field names may change the order of fields in MongoDB document. Code on current slide demonstrates different order of JSON output for various models and various versions of Sprite.json library. Adding a new field to the model may change field's order. Different versions of Sprite.json may render fields in different order also. Code on this slide defines test exchange rate model. Note that ID of this model contains two fields, base currency and date. Current slide contains two different records with different order of fields in primary keys that we inserted to MongoDB. ID in first record has base currency field and then date field. ID in second record has date field and then base currency field. Code on current slide contains a single filter query defined three different ways. First query created from plain string with explicit fields order. Second query is created from MongoDB driver filters. And third query is created using JSON formats. These filters compiled as shown on slide and return the same expected record. The previously mentioned queries for second record will return null results. This happened because filter fields order doesn't match second record fields order. And this is completely expected behavior, because if the filter value is a document, then the order of fields in the document matters and should be properly reflected. Code on this slide contains plain query where fields order matches second record fields order. This query will print second record as expected. MongoDB allows to use dot notation to specify a query condition on fields in embedded or nested documents. In this case, order of fields in query doesn't matter. Code on this slide demonstrates utilization of dot notation filter. In this case, exception will be thrown as Bison document can be created from basic types. Code on current slide creates dot notation filter with plain types. This query will not bring desired results as date value rendered as string. Code on this slide defines two dot notation filters from plain strings, and both queries will work well and return records from MongoDB. All previous queries were defined as plain strings. However, filters in MongoDB are also JSON. As such, it should be possible to reuse JSON formats to write queries. This already implemented in Greenleaf Mongo DSL, and a few examples of queries presented on this slide. Code on this slide utilizes Greenleaf Mongo DSL and defines filters for exchange rate test model. Both queries return records because DSL transforms simple filter to dot notation query. It's important to point out that dot notation queries have some limitations. For instance, it's impossible to use dot notation inside in query operator. Queries in this case will return nothing because no records will match the query. But dot notation queries works well inside OR operator as shown on this slide. Code on this slide shows error that MongoDB return when update query uses dot notation on primary key and the record doesn't exist. Previous error is expected and described in MongoDB documentation. One more important type is option. Code on this slide contains geographical record test entity with complex key. The key contains two optional fields, state and city. Filter on current slide will not work as expected. It was defined as explicit query by primary key, but This record returns all records where country equal to USA, along with state and cities records. To fix previous query, optional fields state and city should be explicitly defined as nulls. In MongoDB, expression item equal to null match documents that either contain item field with null value or do not contain this field at all. By default, spray.json doesn't render undefined none values in JSON. Null option state should be mixed to Bison protocol to successfully render none as nulls in related JSON representation. Once null option state added to Bison protocol, queries with optional fields will work as expected. Query by country code will return single related record. Query by state code will return single record also. The filters work as expected because none fields rendered as explicit null values, and MongoDB will skip records that contains some values in these fields. Find queries in MongoDB Scala driver return find observable of Bison document. Code on this slide defines DSL that allows to transform observable to future of sequence option or object utilizing related JSON protocols. Find one and replace and find one and update queries return single observable. DSL for this type will be similar to previous one and displayed on current slide. Greenleaf MongoDAO trait extends Greenleaf MongoDSL and provides simple DSL for queries and transformations from MongoDB's observable types to futures. This trait also provides many useful generic methods, such as insert, find by ID, update by ID, replace by ID, etc. Code on this slide demonstrates the ease of preparing test model building Bison protocol that will be used in DAO. DAO Bison protocol with related ID and entity types should be mixed to Bison protocol. Code on this slide shows how to define DAO for test building model. The class should extend Greenleaf MongoDAO and define related Bison protocol. That's it. Insert, find by ID, update by ID, and rest of command types are already available and ready for use. Additional custom queries can be defined utilizing queries DSL. There are four key points to take away from this presentation. Greenleaf JSON protocol provides all JSON formats from Spray's default JSON protocol. JSON formats for additional types such as zone date time and scalar enumeration also defined. All these JSON formats can be overridden. Greenleaf Bison protocol extends Greenleaf JSON protocol and overrides JSON formats for some types as required for Bison serialization. Greenleaf MongoDSL provides DSL that allows to write queries with syntax that is more close to real queries in MongoDB. And Greenleaf MongoDAO extends Greenleaf MongoDSL, defines DSL for Mongo's observable types, and provides topical methods such as insert, find by ID, etc. The code of this extension is available on GitHub via the following link. The library also published on Maven repository and can be used as SBT dependency. All further details are provided in README on GitHub. Thank you.
Hi, thanks for your talk. Please say, Greenleaf protocol DSL works on runtime or compile time?
On runtime.
Why?
Because JSON works on runtime, right?
There are such library, SQL, that translates Scala code using some macro transformations into in compile time into raw plain SQL strings. It would be possible to do such thing in your library?
I'm not sure, because I used SprayJSON, and SprayJSON will transform it at runtime, right? I do not write my own serialization. I reuse existing library to do it. But who knows?
Okay, thanks. And just one more question. I see that your library allow to chain and explicitly cast received bisons to sequence of objects. It's not very type safe. It's too easy to make some mistakes that compiler would be prevent, but in your case it shouldn't. Can this be fixed in any way?
Okay, so if I understand correctly, last question was related to DSL transformation of this one, right?
This one and the last two lines.
Last two lines. Okay. This is a method from MongoDB Scala driver, which is return single observable, which will contain option of value in all these cases.
So,
it will be typed and it will be document, because by default MongoDB Scala driver provides codecs to work with Bison documents only. So ever it will be type Bison document, and the library makes transformation utilizing formats of related model in JSON to transform this Bison to JSON and then convert to some type defined by user, right?
If I understand you correctly, there is no more type safety than plain JS object in spray.
Absolutely correct. So yes, if, let's say, collection contains documents that describe, I don't know, some different type, let's say, building, but we would run query by exchange rate, then yes, it will be runtime error, because JSON is not able to deserialize data that presented in different format. Absolutely the same as in regular API request, right? Yeah. Any additional questions?
So when we choose MongoDB, we expect that exists some library which look like some sleek for SQL,
yeah,
which is type safe. Do you know something which can help us?
Again, not in this case, right? Because even if you will use official driver, latest version of the driver that allows to utilize macros as to create codecs, and you create collection with some user types, again return to our previous query, building, but actually this collection contains not building model but records related to some exchange rate or something different, you will get error in runtime. When not JSON will work on deserialization this data to model, but Bison codecs defined by driver will give you the similar error. Anyone else? Yes. Not yet, but I can add it. So if it needed, sure, we'll do. Absolutely. Yeah.
Actually, really great work. You are trying to summarize all your pains in the neck.
Yeah.
I'm on your side because I'm also working a lot with MongoDB. But with regular driver, mm-hmm. I know that this zone is not so convenient as other serializer, especially you use it. But do you have something like hints and tricks working with Mongo? Because I saw lots of resources, and I think this information is really useful as handbook because. Not only you suffered pain with optionals, not only you suffered pain with these data formats, with number formats. I can add from my side that if you keep number as string, it's not the same as number, I mean regular number.
Yep.
So do you have such a resource, maybe on Medium or? Or maybe you plan to do something like that?
Sorry, currently I didn't get your last questions. Could you please repeat?
Maybe you plan to summarize all this information on such resource like Medium.
Ah, I see. I didn't get Medium. That you means blog. Okay, I see it. Actually, I didn't have this plan, but. Since I received at least one question, maybe I will do it. So thank you for proposal. Yeah.
I have a question. Have you ever tried to adapt those things to reactive Mongo driver as well? Maybe you have some adaptation layer there.
I will come close because I didn't hear well.
I mean, have you tried the same approach to adapt it to reactive Mongo driver, not the synchronous one?
Okay, actually, guys, for reactive Mongo, it's the similar extension already exists, and it called reactive Mongo play JSON. But
yeah.
I would say that I don't use play JSON. Every day, so I work with spray JSON, and I don't use reactive Mongo. I use plain official Scala driver. So I decided to create something similar that exists for play and play JSON, which is extension for reactive Mongo. And at the same time, I would note that currently, as I see, reactive Mongo doesn't support all. When I talk about reactive Mongo, at least I'm talking about this reactive Mongo extension for PlayJSON, that they do not support big decimal formats. And they have demo where explicitly described maximum value can be more than double dot max value. So yeah, this issue. And another nice feature that's really DSL, because I don't see any tricks with transformation of queries to dot notation queries. And probably, if for some reason PlayJSON will make some changes, maybe in internal data structure, like SprayJSON did last year, and ordering of fields changed, then PlayJSON extension for reactive Mongo will have absolutely the similar issue related to ordering of fields. And it should be implemented on their side something similar to explanation of these dot notation queries, etc. And of course, these queries looks really awesome, right?
another one, small one. Basically, I think that probably it's not really nice to expose that you are using Mongo externally, and probably it's good to like at least rename the underscore ID with ID or rename it to something like key or something. Do you have maybe some technical error?
Yes, actually, DAO already defines primary key name, and by default, this is underscore ID. But it's possible to be overridden. So if you don't want to, let's say, create additional JSON format for Bison representation where you want to override ID to ID underscore, then yes, it's possible to do in Monga DAO and define that primary key is ID without underscore or ID without or just key or something else. And all methods that were described in this presentation, common methods like insert, find by ID, update by ID, replace by ID, etc., will use this primary key name. So it works. Additional information on GitHub, a lot of tests, examples, etc. Anyone else? Okay, in this case, thank you for your attention. Thank you for your time. Thanks.